Welcome back, everyone. Today I'm talking about kill switches. A lot of people do not have kill switches. They just pull in the clutch or they choke it and kill it that way. I've personally seen people have their throttle stick and crash, and maybe if they had a kill switch, they could have hit that and saved themselves. Kill switches are inexpensive. You can get them pretty much anywhere. I like this one. It's just a single button. You can get it on Amazon for a couple bucks. I'll put a link to some that I like in the description below. I'm going to show you really quick what the switch does. This is a multimeter. I have it set to continuity, and that'll just tell me when there's continuity. So right now there isn't. Now there is. And we want to use this to ground out the coil. This is our external ignition coil, and this is the line that comes from the stator, which gives it spark. If we interrupt this wire or we ground it out, it'll kill the bike because it won't have spark anymore. So all we need to do is splice into this wire, and then whenever we press that button and ground it out, it'll die. These are the wires that are coming from the stator. This is the wire that goes to the coil. Normally they would just connect, and I'm going to cut this off and make a little pigtail so I can plug it in, and one wire will go to the coil and the other wire will run to the kill switch. All right, I got my little pigtail here. This one's gonna run all the way up to the kill switch, and this end's gonna run to the coil. If you wanna see how I made this connection, check out this video all about wiring. I'm gonna run two wires up to the front for the kill switch. I do need the grounding wire and then the wire that goes to the coil. So I'm gonna put a ring terminal on this and ground it. Perfect. I'm gonna put the ground right here. Now we have our ground cable and our kill cable. These will run up to the handlebars. Now that we have our two wires, we have to fish them up the frame. The easiest way to do this is to get another piece of wire and put that down the frame and then pull them through. Okay, there we go. I would just use some electrical tape and tape them together really nice and snug. Make sure there's no snags on this end that's gonna be pulled through. And now just kind of feed it up. Pull it through really gently. All right. I'm gonna mount the kill switch now so I know how long to make the wires. I'm gonna shorten these wires right about here and these ones right about here. Connect them, shrink wrap them. Give yourself a little extra room just in case you mess up. If you're gonna do shrink tubing, remember you have to do this before you connect the wires. I'm gonna twist these and then solder them. You do not need to solder them. You could just use spade connectors or any kind of connector you want. I'm just gonna do a solder, because why not? There's one, and there's two. Then I use a little heat gun. And now I can slide over the larger shrink wrap. Perfect. That goes over. Then we can pull these wires a little bit in. There we go, it's all wired up. That's all it takes to wire up a kill switch. It's super easy, two wires, just ground out the coil and you're done. I hope this video helped you. Please like and subscribe.